I'm pleased to present the surveillance data analysis. Surveillance data analysis of HIV/AIDS in Tunisia from 1986 to 2016. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, AIDS, remains a problem of public health in the world. In 2016, UNAIDS estimates showed that 36.7 million people are living with HIV in the world. 230,000 living with HIV in the Middle East and North Africa, to which Tunisia belongs. 997 PL HIV are living in Tunisia. Among them, 42% are unaware of their infection. The objective of our study is to analyze the epidemiological patterns of HIV/AIDS in order to characterize the dynamics of HIV epidemic and to identify determinants of its potential spread in Tunisia. For this, we used triangulation that is defined by WHO as the synthesis of results from multiple data sources for evaluation and decision making. Multiple data sources were used to provide an overall picture of the HIV epidemic in Tunisia, including routine surveillance data, enhanced surveillance among key populations, such as biobehavioral surveys, BBS, and modeling methods which are used to provide national estimates such as spectrum model from UNAIDS. The data were entered and analyzed by Microsoft Excel, Office Excel version 2007, and BBS analyzed by SPSS. The results of our study, since the declaration of the first case in 1986 until December 31st, 2016, the National AIDS Program registered 2,357 cases, HIV cases. Deaths are 638 cases, and the prevalence among general population is 0.015%. In fact, the dynamics of the epidemic is determined by the rate of at which the new infections occur related to deaths cases. At this stage of the national epidemic in Tunisia, we can see that the new infections registered are more than deaths. Here, you could see that the mortality related to AIDS is decreasing. There is a reduction of mortality and morbidity related to AIDS. Due to this, in green, the mortality in green, due to this, the number of PLHIV is growing in red. You can see this in red. For the incidence, we can identify three periods. The first, since 1986 2000. Before 1995, the incidents were growing to attend a peak, a first peak of 1.05 by 100,000 of inhabitants. Between 1995 and 2008, the incidents were downwarding to a peak of 0.51. And since 2009, the incidence is increasing, and this could be partly explained by the development of testing and counseling activities and the establishment of an MNE plan for the response to HIV/AIDS. For the AIDS proportion, we can see that before 2000, the number was growing and still more than half of the HIV cases. After the introduction of the antiretroviral therapy, there was a decreasing of the number, and this decline was accelerated since 2009 to attend one third of HIV cases in 2016. For the sex ratio, we can see that the number of the sex ratio is decreasing since the beginning of the epidemic. Before 2000, it was more than three, and after it is decreasing to attend two in 2016. That we explained by the first mode of transmission, that is heterosexual relations. The number of women is growing unless exceeding the number of men. For the modes of transmission, we can see that the first mode of transmission in women is the heterosexual relations, and for men, the first is heterosexual trans relations, but the second is injecting drug use. For the age of the detected cases, for men and women, the young people are predominantly infected, affected by the infection. It is between 30 and 35 years old. Three biobehavior surveys were conducted in 2009, 2011, and 2014, and they showed that the prevalence of HIV is higher than 5% among MSM. It is relatively stable among sex workers and injecting drug users. For the results of the estimates by a spectrum of UNAIDS, so we can see that the incidence is growing, and it is different of data observed by the National AIDS Program. Here you can see that the incidence is growing, but the projections to 2018, it will be decreasing. So the HIV epidemics in Tunisia could be characterized by the after the analysis of national data. It is still at a controllable level at the general population. This highlights the importance of the response in terms of prevalence and care, prevention and care. This epidemic is concentrated among key populations. The sex ratio tends to fall, and it confirms distribution of transmission modes. It is a hidden epidemic because a significant percentage of people do not know their HIV status, according to the estimates. This epidemic is similar to the epidemics in countries of MENA region and of Maghreb. We currently have very rich data until now, three series of biobehavior surveys of key populations, mapping of these key populations with size estimates, but we have a problem of representativeness of the whole country. These surveys are limited to coastal areas and large cities in Tunisia. In conclusion, so the HIV epidemic in Tunisia is at low prevalence, stable in the general population, controllable, concentrated among key populations. It is a hidden epidemic similar to that in the region of Middle East and North Africa. So we recommend to focus interventions on key populations by increasing screening and prevention efforts, establish a communication strategy helping to reach key populations, and we recommend to improve data representativity. We recommend to conduct more surveys at national level. Thank you. My acknowledgements to Professor Nisaf Benalaya and all the team of the National AIDS Program in Tunisia.
Thank you, Hayat, for your presentation about HIV situation in the country. Now, I open floor for the questions.
Okay, I have some questions. I have a lot of questions, but I'm going to be focused on two questions. For example, you have shown a very increasing in incidence of HIV/AIDS from 2012. That is difficult to understand under the basis of the dynamic of the epidemic. Maybe it is because of the delay in reporting, or maybe it is not well extended, the antiretroviral treatment, or, well, when you're speaking about mortality, is mortality or letality? Because you are providing this data from the AIDS and HIV registry, so is rather letality? And regarding the recommendation, you have recommended screening, but screening is a big recommendation. Are you maybe recommending voluntary counseling and testing, maybe, rather than screening? Because screening implies to a tamizage from the population. So, what is the?
Thank you. for your questions. For the increasing of incidence from 2009, since 2009, we put voluntary testing and anonymous testing in some centers, and we generalize it in 2011. So due to this, we have strengthening the testing voluntary testing. So we have more and more cases of new infections. For the screening, we have different modalities of screening. We have the voluntary testing, and we have also the testing among pregnant women, and we have the control of blood donors. Different, and we have sometimes the campaigns of testing among general populations.
I have, if the floor does not have any question, I have some question. Maybe the, sorry, is there a question from, okay. Adela.
Thank you very much for the excellent presentation that really covers and illustrates very well all the picture, the epidemiology of HIV in Tunisia. My question is related to the mother-to-child transmission. I assume that you are presented, so the data are aggregated for the 15 or 10, yeah, 20 last years. Do you still have cases of mother to child transmission among the new infections? So the question, I would assume that you screen all the pregnant women and they are put under treatment. Is that the protocol in Tunisia? Just if you can expand further on that.
Yes, we have, we are having, we are still having the mother-to-child transmission of HIV, but it is decreasing. We have 2 to 3 cases by year, and we have 52% of mothers covered by the prophylaxis, and we are using the B+ protocol. Your second question? You have another question? Okay.
Thank you. Maybe just last few comments. Thank you for the presentation about the epidemiological situation with HIV in the country. I think maybe it will be useful also to have data on late diagnosis of the new cases, newly registered cases, which could serve as a proxy for the prevalence of HIV in the country. And maybe some data about the cascade, about the treatment in the country, how many people are actually covered, if you have some data.
Yes. The treatment, we have more than 900 covered by the treatment. Known patients are 100% covered by the treatment. By if we use the estimates, so we have 50% covered.
And about the late diagnosis, do you have the data
for the
like HIV cases or low CD?
The cascade, we are
no, now not for cascade, just for the late diagnosis of the cases.
Yes, the average is 5 years. Mm-hmm. Okay. Of delay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.